The horses and drivers are coming onto the track. This is the big one, the Kin Pace. Field of three-year-old fillies going 1 mile for $50,500. Let's meet the field. Number one, Creme Delight, is owned by Rachel Breathour, Sunderland, Dean Lockhart, Wayne Carlton, and Dean Campbell. Murray Breathour trains. Rachel Breathour is the groom. Jay Bradley Harris up, winner in 155-3 at Georgian Downs on June 18th. Solid runner-up finish a week ago, Creme Delight. Number two, Raptors Win. Currently your 2-1 second choice, trained by Nick Gallucci for Miller Farms of Stouffville. Louis-Philippe Roy here in town this afternoon. Dave Tyrell, the groom, the winner in 156 flat and also winner of the OSS Grassroots at Western Fair in 154-4. Raptors Won. Number three, War We Expat. Owned by Jeffrey Courchain of Cambridge, Mart West Racing Stable, Mississauga. Gabriella Sasso trains, also the groom. Brett McDonald drives. Warwe Expat, a runner-up to Raptors One in that OSS event at London, second a week ago behind Velvet Stinger. Number four, Lion's Princess. Winner of two divisions of the City of London Pacing Series, is owned by Three Leons Racing of Brantford. Anthony Beaton trains. Abby Eves is the groom. Anthony Hahn aboard Lion's Princess. Number five, Velvet Stinger. Currently your 9-5 betting choice, owned by the Miller Farms of Stouffville. Nick Gallucci trains. Candace Nins is the groom. James McDonald will drive. Velvet Stinger's won 4 of 5, including a division of the Kin Eliminations a week ago. Also a winner of the OSS at Western Fair in May, Velvet Stinger. Number six, Watcher Fly, is owned by Nurko Sokolovic of Waterloo and Craig Bars of Cobourg. Craig Bars trains. Rhonda Slack is the groom. Travis Henry aboard Watcher Fly, winner of her debut at Flamborough Downs, and solid fourth place finish a week ago, Watcher Fly. Number seven is Ribbon Ridge, owned by Ross Holmes of London, Bud Sinclair of Stratford. Bud Sinclair is the trainer. Lindsay Sinclair is the groom. Tyler Borth will drive Ribbon Ridge, winner of $30,000 in 2021, mainly from runner-up finishes. Still looking to find her form this year. Number seven, Ribbon Ridge. Rounding out the field, number eight is Sexy Playmate, owned by Kyle Bossens of Arthur. He is the trainer. Steve Quinn is the groom. Trevor Henry will drive Sexy Playmate, the winner of the City of London Pacing Final at Western Fair at the end of May in 155-1. Able to get into this final off a fourth place finish a week ago here at Clinton Raceway, Sexy Playmate. An outstanding field of 8 3-year-old pacing fillies. They're going 1 mile for $50,500. It is the Kin Pace final. Who will win the Kin? It's post time. This field is now in motion, and here they come. They're off and pacing with a dash from the lead. Raptors One along the inside. Also firing early was Creme Delight. Into third position goes Warawi Expat around that far turn. Now up to take over fourth is Velvet Stinger. Fifth along the inside, that is Lion's Princess. Then we're back to Sexy Playmate, Watcher Fly, Ribbon Ridge, eight in the line now as they roll to the opening quarter. Louis-Philippe Roy has Raptors One on the engine here. They reach that marker, 27-2. The tempo is on us. Pocket sitting second is Creme Delight. Racing in third, Warawi Expat. Velvet Stinger sees it from fourth. Fifth is Lion's Princess. Then we're back to Sexy Playmate, Watcher Fly, Ribbon Ridge. No change in positions. Raptors 1 looking strong on the engine here. Roll by the half. 55-4. They're flying around the Huron County Oval in the Kin Pace Final. Raptors 1 shows the way. Racing second is Creme Delight. Here comes Warwee X-Pad up and at it, followed to the outside by Velvet Stinger. Those four with a little separation as they roll to the three quarters. Raptors 1, half a length to the good. Warwee X-Pad is second. They're once around the track and they're halfway back. Zoom, 124-4. Warwee X-Pad puts a head in front. Here comes Velvet Stinger on the outside as Raptors 1 has surrendered. Velvet Stinger takes the lead. Creme Delight is coming on late. This one belongs to Velvet Stinger. Give it up, folks. The Kin Pace champion and new co-track record holder here at Clinton Raceway, Velvet Stinger. A black three-year-old filly by Better's Delight and our hot majorette, owned by the Miller Farms of Stouffville, Nick Gallucci, the winning trainer. James McDonald returns to the winner's circle here again this afternoon at Clinton Raceway. Velvet Stinger victorious here in 154-3. A popular winner indeed, posing for the camera. There she is, Velvet Stinger.
Circle with James McDonald, winning driver of the Kin Pace 2022 aboard Velvet Stinger. And you know, I gotta ask you first, I know I had spoke to Nick before the race and he even said he was surprised that you went with this one over Raptors 1. You talk a little bit about that decision first.
Yeah, you know, last week she was just so strong. She finished I never really asked her. She'd never cut a race before. In the last eighth I kicked the plugs and she was just pacing out of her harness. So you know, I like Raptor, and it was obviously a tough decision, but Velvet's been so brave coming in, and she's Nick's got her firing on all cylinders, so I was happy to drive her.
All right, and we've got Griffin with us here today. Griffin, do you like watching Dad win races?
Yes.
All right, there you have it. Griffin likes watching you win. And you know what, James, it feels like, you know, every time I meet you in the winner's circle, you're adding another trophy, right, to your trophy case. And what's it like to put this one in the record books now, Kin Pace victory?
Well, fun fact, you don't get many of the trophies. I would like to have a trophy case with them in it, but I don't think there'd be a Kin Pace trophy for the driver. But no, it's great. Anytime you can win signature races, you see a good crowd like this tonight and all the kids here cheering everyone on, it's special. So it's fun. Anytime you can win a big race is great. And now I got the Kin Pace off my bucket list and can move on.
All right, we got to get James a trophy though for the Kin Pace. And just real quick, I mean, I'm going to bring Nick in next. The relationship you guys have is incredible. You know, you, Nick, and Millar Farms. Just talk a little bit about that. I mean, relationships are so important in harness racing. You know, talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, I think it's important just to kind of be on the same page. And you know, for the most part, Nick and I and George, we all have kind of the same mentality when it comes to horses. You know, I'm sure sometimes they'd like to strangle me the way I drive them, but for the most part, they know I'm trying to do my best out there and take care of their horses and, you know, get them to spots like this where they can win these races. You know, it means a lot, and it's always great having great people in your corner. Nick's doing a great job training these horses. George is the easiest owner in the world to drive for. They never give me a hard time, and, you know, that makes my job a lot easier.
All right. right. Well, thanks, James. Congratulations again. Congrats, Griffin. Thanks for coming out today, buddy. Let's bring in Nick Gallucci now, winning a trainer, Velvet Stinger. So we talked before the race. You said you made a shoeing change on this one. It wasn't the prettiest going horse, you know, a few starts early on, especially at Western Fair. Still won that race.
Yeah.
But what was the shoeing change that you made again?
I switched her from steel to aluminum just to try to get her gait a little bit lower. So she was interfering, bringing her right front foot into her left knee. Now it seems like she's starting to go underneath the knee, which is, you know, very beneficial for her gait and ability to carry speed throughout the mile.
And she seems like she's got some real wicked gears, you know, like that race at Western Fair, it seemed like she had no chance at any point, still won today. I mean, obviously a nice trip, but, you know, kicked on nicely to tie the track record here. What do you think the ceiling might be for this horse?
I'm sorry, what was that?
The ceiling, like where do you think she ends up?
You know, so far this year, it's been actually a really nice surprise. We were even questioning if we were going to race her this year or not, just because, like you were saying, her gait was so bad before. But right now, she seems like she's changed the gears really well, and that's what you need to do when you have a pacer. And we'll see. I mean, the next Golds at Grand River, 54 here, should get her competitive there. But we'll play it by ear and see how she seems going into that.
And what about, I mean, Raptors won, still a decent enough effort to finish fourth today. I mean, were you happy with that performance?
Well, not necessarily. I mean, she looked like she was pretty grabby on the front. Hopefully we can get her to settle a little bit more for her next race. I mean, you're not going to win too many races if you get over the half in 55. So we'll see how she seems after the race and go from there.
All right. Is there anything we can look forward to? Any babies coming up that we can tell the people at home to watch for?
I'm going to qualify on Saturday, Pacing Filly, Save the Last Dance. She's Silver Label's full sister. I'm pretty excited about her.
All right, thanks, Nick. Congratulations again. Nick Gallucci, winning trainer, Velvet Stinger of the Kin Pace 2022. Back to you guys.